Professor Chase. My name is Hal Dan Chase. I am the director of the Confucius Institute. And Mr. Yuhua Zhou is our Chinese director. Okay? The way it's set up with the Confucius Institute is that it's a partnership between the College of the Bahamas and Confucius Institute headquarters, as well as Nanjing University of Information Science and Technology. And so what it is that COB is required to provide office space and so on for the Institute, along with supplies and all of that. And Confucius Institute headquarters, through the University of Nanjing University of Information Science and Technology, which you refer to as NUIS for short, is where Professor Zhou comes from, along with Professor Zhang. So we have two teachers who've come to us from that university, which is our sister university in China. The Confucius Institute is really, the main mission of Confucius Institutes is to promote the learning of Chinese language and culture. That's written very, very large. Of course, you know, China has many languages, but the official language, the lingua franca of China, is Mandarin. Okay, all of the official work that is done in Mandarin. So that's the language that we are focused on. You are ready to give yourself one of the greatest gifts any young person can receive. You can see from the itinerary that there is a combination of tours and also classroom instruction that combine together for this experience. Okay? The ideal is that you would go to China having some knowledge of Mandarin. And we, to be quite frank with you, are going to give first preference to those students who have already done some courses in Mandarin, or who show a willingness to do a Mandarin course, which we will offer especially for selected students in the summer. It's a short course, but it's intensive, and it's really intended for you to be able to take full benefit of what is offered in China. The more you're able to communicate, the more you're able to understand, the richer I think your experience will be. But if we don't get, you know, from among our students a significant number that have knowledge of Mandarin, then of course we open it up to all students who would like to go. And the mere fact that you're a student at COB makes you eligible for consideration. Right. We had a group event last year, among them Kim Lee. She can probably tell you all a bit about her experience as well. I mean, we have a real live person who went, and Mr. Zhou served as one of the guys. When you go to China, you're not going to live in five-star hotels. All right? I mean, that's a fact. This is university-based, and so for the most part, your accommodations will be what a university student will benefit from. Okay, you're not going to go there and think to stay in a hotel like Atlantis. It's not like that. You're going to stay in a university dorm, except when you go on tours, excursions, then you'll be staying at what would be considered the appropriate level of hotels. Okay? The deal is this. You are responsible for half of your airfare. And we are responsible for half. And all of your on-the-ground expenses are covered by us, by the Institute, by NUIS, and by Confucius headquarters. So your financial outlay basically is limited to half of your airfare. Now when it comes to your spending money, obviously that's on you. If you want to do any special excursions while in China that are not a part of the itinerary, that's up to you as well. You will have to pay for that, all right? But as far as the rest of it goes, that is the scholarship part. But of course, I think when people are invested in their own experiences, they tend to have a bit more appreciation for them. And not only that, remember we are just one small country in the world. And there are many, many, literally thousands of young people from around the world who are competing for the same kinds of opportunities. And so we have to bear that in mind and not take it for granted that, you know, these things are just available to us and us alone. But in the Caribbean region itself, there is a move by the Chinese government to encourage the language and cultural learning. Okay, so that in a nutshell is what we are offering to you.
So it's not open to other young people not enrolled at COE?
To be honest, in the past we have done that, all right? But the proviso is that you take part in that special summer session. Okay, you can't just come in cold. Okay, you have to be a part of that at least. All right. So we were able to, because it was the first time we did it for the Summit camp, we didn't get the, you know, we were made a bit more, I should say, lenient, right, as far as the disability was concerned. All right, and we plan to do the same thing again. Now the age limit, or the age range, is basically 18 to 30. That's what we've been told. All right, so you have to bear that in mind as well. All right. Now, this is not to say that, you know, if you tell you one, tell you two, or whatever, you know, qualify. I'm not saying that. But I'm also saying, thinking from the point of view of you yourself. I mean, if 18-year-olds are going and 20-year-olds are going, and you are a little older, I mean, depending on how you see yourself within such a group. I mean, me myself, I don't probably age personally, you know, once we're all of a certain level of maturity. But strictly speaking, it's designed for young people between the ages of 18 and 20 who are behaving citizens. That's another thing. Okay, you have to be a citizen of the Bahamas. 18 to 30. Yeah, a citizen of the Bahamas. Because again, it has to do with international cooperation, which is done at the level of citizens of countries.
This kind of summer camp scholarship are offered by Hanban, which is Confucius Institute headquarters, as provide for CUB students who choose Mandarin class. Right, like Mandarin class, Mandarin 3, Mandarin class, or general transport. If we have enough of Mandarin class students, as for the other CUB students, we can wait. But I don't think we have enough Mandarin class students. We have a limit of 15 students, and at most 20. So if everything goes smoothly and everything shows us, we can organize a group of at least 15 of you to China. And you can see this itinerary. This is based on the, this is preliminary, okay? And you can see there is a note. If everything is possible, when the summer camp really comes to final, and there is some maybe minor or later on came there, you could explain a little bit about this. Hopefully early July or late June, and then 3 weeks, 19 days in China. This could be not from Nassau to United States, but that's the equivalent of this, okay? The first day is in China, and then come back. So that is 19 days, that's 3 weeks, almost 3 weeks. And as for the statistics, when we organize, we will have a special training before we go, our training class. You, at least you know some Mandarins. Okay, some of them are my students, most of them are not. Some of them I know, most are not. But from now on, from today on, if you really want to go, you can go to the internet online. It's very, very resourceful now online. Just type Chinese pinyin. There are many very easy videos. Okay, learn something at the very beginning. I know. Learn a little bit until when spring semester will be ending this April. And then after this, we'll have a training class before we go. You need to pay your round trip tickets first, and then when you return to Bahamas, and you go to half reimbursed here. Okay. As for when you arrive there, accommodation Last year was in hotel, mm-hmm. University hotel. That hotel, I think, if that hotel in Bahamas, how much is one night? $100?
Yeah, I think so.
I think so. One night, so here, if you stay there, $100. So when you stay there, it's free for you, okay? And the food is free for you. Mm-hmm. So including food, that is much more, right? Food. Mm-hmm. And if this travel, we have traveled to several other cities, Hangzhou, Xiamen, also free. But if you want to buy your own things, it's yourself, okay? The Chinese are not kind of for this. Some of them bought many things they like. They like. It's inexpensive, the quality is good. And even some, one of them even buy a suitcase, one suitcase to pack it, to make more package. Okay, so that's another one thing. You must be disciplined. The China has so much population, huge population. It's different from what you imagine.